Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My brothers and sisters, as I said in the previous session, sometimes out of desperation, people tend to visit those who cast spells, those who engage in superstitious behavior, those who do some black magic, those who actually engage in the displeasure of the Almighty. They invoke Satan to help them. They sometimes get the assistance of the jinn kind to help them. They do that which is unacceptable in the eyes of Allah. All this is out of desperation. People do it in order to separate those whom perhaps they want to see separate because they don't get along with them. We were talking about how sometimes people don't want their children to marry certain people, or whether it's male or female, and therefore they go in out of desperation. Instead of calling out to Allah for help and guidance, instead of following what Allah says, they decide to actually go out and cause the loss of their own belief in Allah by using that which Allah has prohibited, which is to cast spells, to do magic, or sometimes to actually use the jinn in order to help them. So they will go to people. There are different types of people. Some of these don't belong to Islam. Some of them say they belong to Islam. Some of them appear so religious and they say, don't worry, I will do some deed. Give me the name of this person, the mother's name of this person. And don't worry, I will make sure that they are separated. Sometimes people do magic on their own family members. Sometimes they do it on their in-laws, or sometimes they do it on their siblings. And I want to say, this is not only prohibited, but it withdraws you from the belief in Allah, who says, no matter what it is, you call out to Allah and you try your best within the acceptable means that the Almighty has given you. So say, for example, if your child does not want to marry the person you want them to marry, they want to marry someone else whom you don't want. Number one, do you have a reason? Do you have a valid reason? If you do, you can talk to them, you can convince them, you can try and explain to them, but you shouldn't be shoving your opinions down their throats. If you haven't managed to convince them and you tried again, you can get someone else to talk to them. They may be convinced. You can pray to Allah. They may not do that, but you cannot go beyond that. You cannot become violent. You cannot beat up your children. You cannot go to do magic on them, or to someone who claims to have knowledge of the unseen to the degree that they will be able to help you with the unseen, make the person quit, make the person do whatever you want them to do. So to try and control people through black magic. Actually, the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, says whoever visits a fortune teller who claims to know the unseen and believes them, has disbelieved in what I have come with, or has claimed that I have cheated in my message. The Prophet, peace be upon him, has never cheated in his message. So another narration speaks about how your prayer is not accepted because you have actually rejected the Almighty and turned to the devil, turned to that which is superstitious, turned to the jinn kind, turned to those who claim to be able to help you besides Allah. So this is very, very dangerous. When you go to these people who pretend like they can solve your problem, they, number one, would be perhaps seeking the assistance of the devil. So it's easy for them to look at you and give you information about you and the past and even what you might be thinking of, and you start thinking, wow, what a pious person. But that's not piety. They've just got your news from the jinn, the qareen that happens to be with you all along. There is a jinn with you and I all the time. There is an angel, there is a jinn. The qareen is actually telling you to do bad. The angel is telling you to do good. So when you have a deed in front of you that needs to be done, if it's good, one side of you will say, do it. And the other side might make you feel lazy. And if it's bad, one side of you will say, don't do it. And the other side might encourage you or show you, that it's spicy, it's juicy, let's just go for it, etc. If you were to listen to the angelic force, you become successful. If you're listening to the devilish force, then you become unsuccessful. So that devilish force or that jinn would actually know your whole history. What happened to you when you were young? Who's related to you? Who's not related to you? Your whole history better than you know it. So when you go to some of these people who are fortune tellers or who claim to be, the word used is amil sometimes, not all of them are a fraud, but a lot of them are, because if they start telling you that of the unseen, lying to you, I say that again. If they start telling you things of the unseen, they are lying to you. And if they tell you who did the magic on you, that is the biggest lie. And if you believe them, you've disbelieved in Allah. That's what Allah says. You've disbelieved in what Muhammad ﷺ has come with, because they lie. I've known of jinn kind that actually lie. Every family has a little bit of a crack in it, in the extended family. The minute something goes wrong with your belly, it's just something you ate. Probably tomorrow or the next day or a week later when the bug is out, you'll feel okay. But in the meantime, we become desperate and so impatient. Rather than waiting for that wind to be passed properly, we go out and lose our faith to see who did what on me. And suddenly they give you names. And those names are people who they know you've got a problem with, because the jinn has told them. So when you have a problem with someone, they didn't do that magic against you, but you think they did it against you. So you actually end up losing your faith by believing an innocent person to be guilty simply because there was a little crack in that relationship, and now they've convinced you that, wow, this person has done some black magic on you. They'll tell you to look to the corner of the ceiling, you'll see a face, that face is of someone, and you recognize the person. That's not the guilty person. That's just the jinn showing you what's going on. Sometimes there is a little bit of truth in what is said, but we need to know it's prohibited to go to such people. It's prohibited to try and destroy a relationship by going to the devil, by casting spells and doing that. If you were to do that, how can you call yourself a Muslim? How can you call yourself a believer in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So my brothers and sisters, let's understand, when you want something, you ask Allah for it and you try your best to get it in the proper legal channels in a way that will not earn the displeasure of Allah. Do not become impatient by trying to do that which makes you lose your connection with the Almighty. At the same time, your deen, your dunya, your akhirah, your religion, your livelihood and your hereafter, all of it is lost. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us and to make it easy for every one of us to be steadfast. Remember, like I said, I actually received not one but many emails saying that, oh, you know, my so-and-so has done black magic because they don't want us to be married with such and such a person. That is happening, and it's happening a lot. If you do that, you're actually doomed, because that black magic comes back to affect you, the doer of it. It will definitely come back to ruin you, your family, your children, because la yahiqul makru sayyi'u illa bi ahlihi. You know, a bad plot and an evil plan will only come back to those who deserve it, and that is the people who have done it in the first place. So don't ever feel the need to try and fix someone by engaging in magic, by going to see a fortune teller, by going to see what is called in Southern Africa, Sangoma, or Nganga, what is in Zimbabwe, that's what they're called sometimes. If it's a herbalist, someone giving you some herbal medication, etc., that's another story. But I'm talking of engaging in that which is superstitious in order to cast spells on people. Those spells come back to you. They will definitely come back to ruin you and your life very, very soon. And they may temporarily give you that ruining of this particular person. You may see a slight result of it and get excited. But remember, it's got nothing to do with Islam. It's prohibited in the deen of Allah. It's not allowed. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us, protect us. And like I say, pray for goodness. Learn to love people. Learn to love the freedom that Allah has blessed people with. Give them that freedom. They can choose their spouses. Let them choose. Guide them. Keep guiding them. As parents, we sometimes feel let down by the choices of our children. But you know what? Engage with them. Talk to them. Convince them. They may be convinced. And if they have someone whom you're just picking on because of something, you know what? We had a comment, one of the comments on the previous post that I posted about how sometimes we're unhappy with the choice of our sons, the choice of our wife. Someone said, you know, as much as we were unhappy, we let it happen. And it turned out to be the best thing. And this person didn't really have wealth, and he turned out to be later on one of the biggest businessmen. Wow. And I said there, I commented by saying, you know what? You followed what Allah wanted, so Allah gave you everything that you wanted. Subhanallah. Amazing. So let's just follow the instructions of Allah, the help of Allah, the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He will help us. I pray you have a beautiful Sunday evening in those places where it is Sunday evening. And those who are still starting their Sunday in the States and the other countries, I pray that you have a good day, the rest of your weekend, and a lovely week ahead. May Allah protect all of us. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.